Assalamu alaikum. How are you, my dear students? Hope all you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am also fine. Welcome to NIBS Home School. This is Amiruddin, Assistant Teacher of Mathematics, Morning Shift, National Ideal English Version School. Dear students, today I am going to take a math class for the students of class 9. Dear students, our today's topic is Mathematics Assignment 5. Dear students, this is lesson number 18. Okay, dear students, now let us start our today's class. At first, we will see the question of today's assignment. Here, you are watching three figures. Actually, these three figures are three graphs you are watching. Now, here it is written that here in each graph, a horizontal line is considered as x-axis and vertical line is considered as y-axis. In each graph, this horizontal line considered as x-axis and this vertical line considered as y-axis. Now, answer the following questions in the light of the graphs. One number question is, write the names of three graphs. Dear the students, here total three graphs exist. We have to find out what is the name of this graph, what is the name of this graph, and what is the name of this graph. At first, in first graph, continuous class interval here. Along x-axis, continuous class interval are line, and along y-axis, that means along vertical line, frequency are line, and you are watching some column is drawn in this figure, so that we can say that this graph is the graph of histogram. Now, second graph. Here, along with x-axis, midpoint of continuous class interval exists, and along with y-axis, frequency exists. And we have joined the midpoint of class interval. This is one midpoint of class interval, this is another midpoint of class interval, this is another midpoint of class interval, another midpoint of class interval, and midpoint of class interval. And here all points are joined so that one bounded region is made, and it has more than four line segments, so that we can say that this is the graph of frequency polygon. Now, three number graph. Here in x-axis, upper limit of class interval exists, upper limit of class interval, and in y-axis, cumulative frequency exists, so that we can say that this graph is the graph of Ogivo curve. Okay, now here the solution of one number exists. Here name of the first graph is histogram, name of the second graph is frequency polygon, and name of the third graph is Ogive curve. Dear the students, we have solved one number. Now we'll solve two number question. At first we'll see what is the question. Here in two number it is written that construct the frequency distribution tables according to the graph 1, graph 2, and graph 3. For graph 1, we'll make frequency distribution table. For graph 2, also we'll make frequency distribution table. And for graph 3, also we'll make frequency distribution table. Okay, at first, frequency distribution table of histogram in graph 1 as follows. We'll make the frequency distribution table of this graph. Here, in this row we have written class interval, and in this row we'll write frequency. first class interval 30 to 35 and then second class interval 35 to 40. This is a continuous class interval, and then 40 to 45, 40 to 45, then 50 to 55, 50 to 55, and then 50 to 55 to 60, 55 to 60. Now, class interval 30 to 35 goes up to 7.7 along with y axis. Here 6 exists, here 8 exists, and this line exists in the middle of 6 and 8, we can consider, so that this frequency will be 7. That means frequency of class interval 30 to 35 will be 7. Now, in second class interval 35 to 40, here this line remaining in the line of the point 4. That means second frequency of this class interval will be 4, 35 to 40, and frequency will be 4. And similarly, we can find out the frequency of 40 to 45 class interval, it will be 8, and frequency of 45 to 50 class interval, it will be 6, and frequency of 50 to 55 class interval, it will be 4, and frequency of 55 to 60, this class interval, it's lies under 2, so that its frequency will be 1. We have made the frequency distribution table of histogram. Now we will make the frequency distribution table of frequency polygon. That means we will make the frequency distribution table of this graph. Here, class interval 20 to 25 and second class interval 25 to 30, third class interval 30 to 35, all class interval continuous. Here class interval is continuous class interval, and frequency of 20 to 25 class interval is 30. And frequency of 25 to 30 class interval is 25, and frequency of 35 to 40 class interval is 35 to 40, it will be 28. It's down to 30, so we will consider it will be 28. And similarly, frequency of 40 to 45, it will be 45, and frequency of class interval 45 to 50, its frequency is 10. Dear the students, now we'll make the frequency distribution table of ogive curve. We'll find out the frequency distribution table of ogive curve. In ogive curve, along x-axis, upper limit of class interval exists, and along y-axis, cumulative frequency exists. So, class interval, first class interval 0 to 10, and second class interval 10 to 20, third class interval 20 to 30, then 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and 50 to 60 exist here. Now, here, cumulative frequency given here, cumulative frequency, first intervals cumulative frequency is 2, and then 7, then 16, then 30, then 35, then 40. We have to find out frequency, and so that for finding out frequency of 0 to 10 class interval, it will be same as cumulative frequency 2. Now we'll find out the cumulative frequency of second class interval. If we subtract these 2 from 7, then we'll get it, and 7 minus 2, this is equal to 5. Now frequency of third class interval, if we subtract 7 from 16, then it will be 9. Again 30 minus 16, this is equal to 14. Then 37 minus 30, this is equal to 7. Then 40 minus 37, this is equal to 3. Dear students, we have made the frequency distribution table of Ogive curve. That means we have made the frequency distribution table of this graph. We have solved two number question. Now we'll solve three number. Here the question is, which graphs of the stem are used to know each over's run scored by team and to compare the total runs scored by two teams in a cricket game? Present logic in favor of your answer. Question is, which graphs among these three graphs, which graphs of the stem are used to know each over's runs scored by a team and to compare the total runs scored by two teams in a cricket game? Okay, dear the students, now we'll write the solution of three number here. In the game of cricket, graph 1 is used to compare the run scored per over. In the game of cricket, graph 1 is used to compare the runs scored per over, and graph 3 is used to compare the total runs of the two teams. Now I will represent the logic in favor of my answer. Here, in first case, I have said that in the game of cricket, graph 1 is used to compare the runs scored per over. Here, first graph it is. The following is an argument in favor of my answer. I have represented here. Considering each class interval from graph 1 as over, we will consider each class interval as over. That means first class interval will consider it is first over, and we'll consider second class interval is second over, third class interval is third over, and fourth class interval is fourth over. And we'll consider frequency as run. This frequency as run we'll consider. That means this first column denotes the runs of first over, and we are watching that from first over 7 run has come, from second over 5 runs has come, and from third over 8 runs has come. Now we can say that this graph, which is similar to the histogram of graph 1, this graph is as similar as the histogram of graph 1. So we can say that in the game of cricket, graph 1 is used to compare the runs scored per over. Now again we have said that graph 3 is used to compare the total runs of two teams. Graph 3, that means this graph is used to compare the total runs of two teams. Now I will represent the argument in favor of this answer. Dear students, at first we will draw two graphs in same graph paper. Here I have already drawn one graph, and I am considering this graph is showing the after finishing each over the runs of team A. That means after finishing first over, the run of team A was 2. And after finishing the second over, the runs of team A was 7. After finishing third over, the runs of team A was 16. After finishing the fourth over, the runs of team A was 30. And after finishing the sixth over, runs of team A was 37. And similarly, after finishing sixth over, the runs of team A was 40. Now we will consider another team, and which name is team B. Suppose that in first over, team B has taken 5 grams. So we'll take a point along 5. Now suppose that in second over team B also has taken 5 runs, so that after finishing second over the runs of team B will be 10. So we'll take another point along the point 10. Suppose that in third over team B has taken 6 runs, that means after finishing third over total runs of team B was 5 plus 5 equal to 10 and 10 plus 6 equal to 16. That means after finishing 10 over, after finishing 3 over, team run of team A was 16 and run of team B also was 16. Now suppose that after finishing 4th over, total run of team B was 27. And consider that after finishing 5th over, runs of team B was 27 and 30. After finishing 6th over, runs of team B will 38. Now if we join, then we'll graph, we'll get the graph of team B. This is the graph of team B. Dear students, one graph will represent total runs in the first 6 overs of one team, that means team A, and another graph will represent total runs in the first 6 overs of another team, that means team B. It is clear from the two graphs which team is ahead till the first 6 overs. We can say that after finishing first over, performance of team B is good, and after finishing second over, performance of team B also good, but after finishing third over, performance of team A and B is same, but after finishing fourth over, the performance of team A is better than team B, and after finishing sixth over, performance of team A is better than team B. It is clear from two graphs which team is ahead till the first 6 overs. To show comparative progress of two cricket teams, always use these ogive curves. Dear students, I have showed the argument in favor of my answer. Dear students, we have finished our today's class. I hope you have understood today's class. So you practice more and more and prepare your assignment 5 and submit as early as possible. Stay home, stay safe, obey your parents' order. Thank you for watching the class. Allah Hafiz.